Have you seen the button in the bottom right corner of most YouTube videos and want to know how to apply your very own? This video explains exactly what a YouTube video watermark is, why you should have one, and how to create and add your own watermark on your own videos. So what is a YouTube watermark? Well, traditionally, a watermark is something that's used to copyright content. For example, if you ask a videographer to help you film and edit videos, they may send you through low quality drafts with a watermark that is visible throughout the video. A draft with a watermark is meant for demonstration purposes only, and the watermark ensures their hard work is not stolen. In this example, you could receive multiple versions of the video, and the videographer knows you're not going to use the draft as the final copy. This ensures the reputation of the videographer is upheld, as they don't want draft versions of their work to be published, and also ensures they can receive payment before the final high-resolution copy is handed over. Now, what's the relevance in that? Well, YouTube watermarks are completely different. So if you're thinking that a watermark will copyright your work or show a large watermark across your video, then you're going to be a little disappointed, or possibly happy, depending on whether you wanted that to happen or not. So if you've never noticed it before, a YouTube watermark is a clickable icon in the bottom right-hand corner of your video. A viewer can click on this button to subscribe to your channel. If you choose, then this is something that can appear on every YouTube video you upload. And for that very reason, most creators display one of two things in the watermark area, either a subscribe button or their logo. Regardless of the image that you choose, the button can only do one thing. It offers the viewer the option to subscribe to your channel and join your community. The majority of creators choose to add a subscribe image because that is actually what is going on, and it makes it super clear for anyone visiting your video that if they click on that, that's exactly what's going to happen. Why should you use a watermark on your videos? Well, if you're looking to increase your subscribers and grow your channel, then this is most definitely something you should have on your YouTube videos, as it is a common place that viewers look to subscribe. It's available on desktop and visible on mobile when users are in full screen mode. However, the button on mobile isn't actually clickable, so that's something just to be aware of. But as you probably know by now, any opportunity we have as creators to encourage the viewer to subscribe is only a good thing. So even if they cannot click it on mobile, it's still an indicator to them to come out of full screen mode and subscribe to your channel. By adding the watermark, I personally consider this as part of optimizing your channel for maximum growth and performance. The watermark on YouTube is so common now that it's actually the minority of videos that don't have it. So if you're concerned about viewers being bombarded with subscribe options, then from my experience, it's very likely that viewers will not get upset by having it in the bottom corner of the screen. My recommendation is to add it because it will improve your chances of increasing your subscribers on every video. So now that you know what a YouTube video watermark is and why you should add one, let's work out how we actually create and then add one to our very own videos. And just in case you're jumping into this video without following through, this is actually part of a series explaining how to set up your YouTube channel from scratch. I'll leave a link in the playlist below if you want to check out the other videos. Now let's jump over to the computer and create a watermark using our free Canva account that we set up in a previous video. So here we are logged into our free Canva account, and we're going to create a brand new image to use as our watermark. There are some requirements that YouTube have on this. The first being 150 pixels square is the minimum size the image can actually be. Now it can be bigger, but it's going to shrink it down to a very small size. So just be aware of that as we create our image. The image also has to be under 1 megabyte in size. So if you create anything too large, it's not going to be something that you can upload to YouTube after you've created it. So firstly, we need to create our canvas, come up to create a design, and then come down to custom size. In the width and height, we want this to be square. And as YouTube have already stated, 150 pixels square is optimum. So add in 150 into both the width and the height, and then click create new design. This is the canvas that we've now got to work with, and you can add anything you like into it. Now, most people either have a subscribe button or a logo. I'm going to create a quick logo just with the basic tools that we've got available to us, similar to what we did in the icon in the previous video. You've also got two options here. If you leave the background completely blank, then you can save it as a PNG and this will appear as transparency on the video. But the alternative is to create a background color so your watermark appears as a square or a shape on each of your YouTube videos. I'm going to use this as the first image to demonstrate with. Come up to share, download, save it as a PNG and click download. That will save to your computer in its default location. The second option you have is actually not having a background. And if you remove the background and then save the image as a PNG file, when you upload this to YouTube, where you see all the white here, that will be transparent on your video. It will look like it's just the Ultimate Gamer logo and then the subscribe. Depending on the size of the logo and the words that you're using, this can look good. It can also look fairly pixelated. So the best thing to do is give it a try and see how it's coming out. If you're having trouble with it, then I suggest using our first option, which uses the background color, and you can use a color that allows your words and your logo to stand out from the standard video. And if you're wondering how you get the YouTube play button with the subscribe, like most people have it, it's up on the screen right now for you to see a demonstration of it. And I've got a link to the exact file that I use in the description below if you want to use that image so you don't have to create your very own. It's entirely up to you. You can do something like we've got right here, or you can use a more standard approach like many other creators do. What I would recommend is having the word subscribe in a clear font is actually quite a good thing, because that's the call to action that you're trying to get from your subscribers, and they will realize that if they see the word subscribe, that's how they can subscribe. Now let's look at how we actually save the image that you've created into YouTube so it appears on all of your videos. First of all, head over to YouTube, click on your icon in the top right, head over to YouTube Studio, come over to Customization, click on the Branding tab, and then the watermark is just here, and you can click Upload, find your image, and then click Open. This will give you the resizing option. If you've chosen an image that isn't square, then you're going to find that you have to cut off some of your image because your video watermark has to be square. Click Done. Now that you've uploaded your watermark, you can now choose between three options of when you want your watermark to display. For most people, they select either a custom start time, which means the watermark appears after the introduction to their video. So you can set that at maybe say 20 or 30 seconds and then it will appear. Or you can have it appear from the very start and go through the entire video. I personally have entire video selected, but you may want to only have it appear after your short introduction. That's entirely up to you. It's more to do with your personal preference. However, I would personally advise avoiding it from the end of the video because you want that button to appear for as long as possible throughout your entire video. Once you've done that, come up and click publish, and then click go to channel. And if you have any videos on your channel, you can now click into your video and you'll see it appear in the bottom right hand corner, depending on the times that you've set on the options on the previous page. If you're watching the playlist all the way through, then make sure you watch the next video. It's clickable on your screen right now. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.